Right now we are starting on with this particular webinar. So I again hope that I am audible to all of you, and if you are having any sort of issue, just raise your hand or let me know. So good morning once again to everyone. A warm welcome from Grover team. I hope that you all are safe and doing good in this pandemic situation. So basically, today's webinar is on Grover's energy management solutions. This particular webinar we are conducting because, as you all know, that the net metering is taking a long time as usual. So in the meantime, instead of wasting the solar power that you have installed, you can utilize that particular power by using the energy management systems, so that whatever the solar energy you are producing, you can use it for your internal consumption, and no extra energy can be exported back to the grid. So this webinar will give you an insight about the various solutions that Grover is offering in this particular segment. So this webinar will be consisting, first of all, a small introduction about Grover as a company, and later on we will be continuing with our main agenda, that is the energy management solutions. I hope my screen is also visible to all of you. Please raise your hands if it is visible. Okay. Starting on with the company profile, I will be giving you a small introduction about Grover as a company, the different products that we are offering for the Indian market, how Grover is performing globally and also in the Indian market for the last 10 years. So this is a small overview about Grover as a company. Starting on with that. So Grover was founded in the year 2010 with an USD capital of $100 million. Basically, Grover is a new energy firm which is dedicated to R&D as well as manufacturing of on-grid inverters, off-grid inverters and storage solutions. Grover is having a range of inverters starting from 750 watt up to 253 kilowatt, and majorly Grover inverters are used in the application of residential rooftop, commercial and industrial rooftop, as well as for the utility segment. Grover is having its business in more than 108 countries worldwide. So with a dream of a green world, Grover takes the opportunity and the initiative to provide a clear and convenient access for green energy. Grover is a customer focused, Grover is a quality focused, and with an experience of 10 years in the field of research and development, we are very much close in becoming the leaders for the smart energy solutions. Talking about the milestones that Grover has achieved in the last 10 years, founded in the year 2010, in the next subsequent year, that is 2011, Grover was the number one exporter of inverters in China. In 2012, Grover became the number one inverter brand in string inverters for the Chinese market. Also, this was the same year in which we received our first investment from Sequoia Capital. In 2016, Grover became the number one brand for the residential segment in China. As well as in 2017, Grover exceeded the shipment of more than 1 million units in terms of string inverters globally. In 2018, We were the top three residential PV inverter supplier worldwide as per the IHS market report. And in 2020, we again reached the milestone of exceeding the shipment of 2 million units globally. So as I've already mentioned, Growatt is the only green energy firm in which Sukla Capital has invested. This is the same investment firm who has given the investments for YouTube, Cisco, Apple, and Google during their initial startup period. Talking about the growth, in 2019, we did a global shipment of 5 gigawatt. In 2020, even though the whole world was affected by the COVID pandemic, still we were able to achieve an 100% growth and did a shipment of more than 10 gigawatt globally. By the end of year 2020, we had done a shipment of more than 2.6 million units, which aggregates to around 27 gigawatt of supply of string inverters globally. We are a team of more than 1,600 employees, out of which 400 are dedicated only for the R&D purpose. More than 400 employees are dedicated for after sales and pre-sales activities, and more than 800 employees are dedicated only for the production purpose. Talking about the rooftop segment in the Indian market, for the year 2019 and 2020, as per the Bridge to India report, Growatt ranked number one for the supply of inverters in the rooftop segment, having a market share of more than 18% to our account. And if you're talking about the international ranking, then as per the UPD Research Lab, Growatt is having the best inverter PV brand certification for more than 9 different countries. Talking about the leaders in the PV industry. So in 2021, as per the IHS market report, Growatt ranks number one for the supply of string inverters in the residential segment. We are having a market share of more than 16% worldwide for the residential segment inverters globally. Also for the string inverters, we rank number four with a market share of 6% for the supply of three-phase string inverters worldwide. Also in 2020, in the storage segment for the supply of hybrid and off-grid inverters, Growatt ranked number two with a market share of 12% globally. And if you're talking about the distributed PV inverter segment, then Growatt ranks number one in most of the countries worldwide. For that matter, Italy, Mexico, Brazil, Vietnam, China. So in all these countries for the distributed PV segment, Growatt ranks number one. Growatt's 20 kilowatt inverter, which was tested by the Photon Lab in the year 2014, is the only inverter till date in the market who has exceeded the maximum efficiency of 99.06%. As per the testing done by the Photon Lab. After that, no inverter has crossed the maximum efficiency of 99% by the testing done by the Photon Lab. Every year, Growatt is spending around 10% of its total income only for the R&D purpose. If you're talking about the cumulative investment for the last 4 years, then Growatt has spent more than $70 million only for the R&D purpose. In 2018, Growatt's Max series of inverter received the number one commercial inverter certification from TUV Rheinland. In 2021, Growatt came up with its new manufacturing facility nearby Shenzhen itself. This particular facility is spread around 2 lakh meter square of area and is having an annual production capacity of 20 gigawatt. It is a completely automated production line which follows stringent quality control. Talking about the global presence, Growatt is spread to more than 14 different countries and is having 14 branch offices worldwide. And coming to the presence of Growatt in the Indian market, right now we are a team of more than 25 people. We are having one Indian director, and to support him, we are having four salesperson and two product managers. For the after sales support, we have a team of more than 15 service engineers, which are situated in different cities of India. Growot is the only inverter manufacturer in India who is having two service centers. One, the first service center is in Hyderabad, whereas the second service center we have started in the year 2020 in Ahmedabad, Gujarat. And cumulative, they carry a total stock of more than 1 megawatt in terms of spare parts as well as spare inverters. Growot started its business in the Indian region in the year 2012-13. So right now it's more than 8 years that Growot is having its presence in the Indian market. More than 30% of the inverters that are installed in the Indian market have crossed their warranty of 5 years and still are working in the field without any issue. Till date, we have shipped more than 1.5 lakh units ranging from 1 kilowatt up to 80 kilowatt, which aggregates to around 2.5 gigawatt of supply of inverters only for the Indian market. Now, coming on to some of the inverters that we are offering for the Indian market. So basically, this particular segment is divided into three different parts. The first one is the residential inverters. Then comes the commercial and industrial inverters. And the third one is the utility-based inverters. So for the residential products, we are having two categories, the single phase and three phase. The single phase inverters comes from 1 kilowatt onwards up to 6 kilowatt, whereas three phase inverters comes from 3 kilowatt onwards up to 15 kilowatts. All Growot inverters in three phase inverters comes with type 2 protection on AC as well as on the DC side, as well as the Growot Mean series, that is the 4 kilowatt up to 6 kilowatt that we are offering for the Indian market, is the only inverter that is coming up with type 2 SPDs on the DC side for lightning protection. For the C&I and the utility product, we are having a range starting from 15 kilowatt onwards. So the Mean series starts from 15 kilowatt onwards up to 40 kilowatt. Basically, this is a dual MPPT model for up to 25 kilowatt, and the 30 to 40 kilowatt comes in three number of MPPTs and four number of MPPTs. Then we are having two more series for 50 kilowatt, that is the MAC series, which comes with three MPPTs, and the MIX series, that is the premium offering from Growot, that comes in six MPPTs as well as seven MPPTs. In couple of months, that is by the end of September 2021, we are also coming up with our 100 and 125 kilowatt inverters with 125 with 10 number of MPPTs. For the utility based segment, we are having the range of inverters from 185 kilowatt up to 253 kilowatt. For the residential energy storage systems, we are having the hybrid inverters ranging from 1 kilowatt onwards up to 100 kilowatt. But for the residential, we are having a range of inverters in single phase from 1 kilowatt onwards up to 6 kilowatt. Whereas for three phase, we are having the range starting from 4 kilowatt onwards up to 10 kilowatt. We are also now started the production of lithium ion batteries. Sorry. So up to 25.6 kWh of battery capacity can be provided for these particular inverters. If you are talking about the microgrid systems, then in this particular segment, we are having a range in single phase inverters, which starts from 2 kilowatt onwards up to 12 kilowatt. So in this particular, we are having the SPF series that starts from 3 kilowatt onwards up to 5 kilowatt. This inverter is a transformerless high frequency inverter, as well as with the inbuilt transformer, we are having a range of inverter which starts from 4 kilowatt onwards up to 12 kilowatt. with the help of the SPF 5000 inverter, it is possible for you to connect this inverter in parallel configuration and extend the capacity up to 30 kilowatt. That is six number of inverters you can connect in parallel for a single phase operation as well as for the three phase operation. And for the monitoring purpose, yes, we are having various options like Wi-Fi, GPRS, 4G dongles, as well as in the last quarter of 2021, we are coming up with the LAN option. Also for larger projects for C&I and a utility, we are having a data logger by the name of ShineMaster 4G, with which it is possible for you to connect up to 64 number of inverters. Our portal is free for 25 years. That is, you don't have to pay any addition charges for using our server. We are having our own application on Google as well as Android and Apple. And also for the laptop or PC viewing, we are having our own portal by the name of Shine Server. Coming on to the last segment of the introduction, these are some of the installations with GrowWatt worldwide and in the Indian market. So this is a special case that I would like to mention. This is the 5 kilowatt model that was installed in the year 2010, and in 2020 the same customer went for the expansion and again went for the GrowWatt inverters. So this particular inverter is still working for the last 10 years without any issue. And then these are some of the installations of GrowWatt. This is a 90 megawatt solar farm that is done with installed with 20 kilowatt inverters. Also 100 megawatt hill solar farm with 40 kilowatt inverters. Again 127 megawatt ground mounted project. Talking about the Indian installation, this is a 5.5 megawatt installation by Kirloskar. Then a 4 megawatt installation in Hyderabad using 200 numbers of GrowWatt inverters, 20 kilowatt. This is the first installation with Max in India. For IIT Hyderabad, 500 kilowatt installation. Again, for Forbes Aurangabad, 1 megawatt installation, where we have also utilized the zero export functionality. Sadhguru Cement in MP, 1 megawatt. 6 megawatt solar farm in Solapur using HE model. So now, this was the introduction about GrowWatt as a company and the products that we are offering for the Indian market and the global market. Now, coming on to the main agenda of today's webinar, that is the solutions that we are offering for the energy management. So, speaking on for the single phase inverters, so when we are talking about the single phase inverters, then all the new X series of inverters that we are offering for the Indian market comes inbuilt with the zero export functionality. The only requirement is that you need to connect an external meter to activate this particular zero export functionality. This particular option can be activated from the display itself or with the online monitoring system that I will be discussing in the next slides. So this is just a system diagram. If you see, without this meter, this is a normal on-grid application which consists of solar panels, an inverter, then this will be the load and the grid. When you want to connect any single phase meter or activate the zero export functionality, in that particular scenario, for a single phase, you need to connect a single phase meter. Now this particular meter comes without CT, so this meter needs to be connected in series, and this meter needs to be in between your load. This is the load and the grid side. So whatever is the load demand that is being continuously read by this single phase meter, and then through RS-485 it communicates with the inverter to you can say ramp down the power or ramp up the power. The same case is with three phase inverters also. In this particular case, there are two options. You can use a meter or a meter which is having the connection of cities. So in this particular case also, the city needs to be connected between the grid and the load, so that whatever the current is flowing from the grid towards the load is being sensed by this city, and then the power is being calculated by this smart energy meter, and through RS-485 the command is given to the inverter to ramp up the power or ramp down the power. So coming on to the meter solutions, so there are two different scenarios. The first one is the direct connection, that is without the help of cities, and the second one is with without the direct connection, that is with the use of cities. So if it is a single phase system for a direct connection, then we are having SPM-E meter. If it is a three phase system, then we are having three phase meter -E, that is TPM-E meter. These both the meters doesn't require any additional CT and can be directly connected between the load and the grid. Now when we are talking about the three phase meter, the only restriction here is that this particular meter can be used up to 40 kilowatt load only, because the maximum current for this particular CT is of 80 amperes. So it can sense only 80 ampere of the load. So we need to take into the consideration that what is the maximum load at the site and accordingly choose the meter. If you don't want to go for a direct connection and need to utilize the CT, then we are having two different models. For single phase, it is SPM-CT, and for three phase, it is TPM-CT. So here you can see a small technical data for both these energy meters. So the maximum RS-485 communication from the inverter to your meter is 100 meters. So you need to take care that whenever you are connecting the three phase meter, the maximum distance of the RS-485 cable should not exceed beyond 100 meters. It is always convenient to have the distance of this RS-485 cable between 50 to 75 meter to have a proper communication. Also, the cities that we are providing with the TPM cities, for the single phase, the city capacity will be 100 amperes, and for the three phase, the city capacity will be 150 amperes. Also, it is not compulsory to go with the cities that we are providing. You can also procure the cities from your side. Only there is a small CT ratio that needs to be changed in the meter, which can be done with the help of our service engineer. And for the monitoring, yes, we are having different sections, that is the LAN-X or the Wi-Fi-X. apart from the single phase, if you want to go for the export control for multiple inverters, then for that particular scenario, we are having one more option by the name of Smart Energy Manager. With this particular Smart Energy Manager, it is possible to control 32 number of inverters at a single time, and maximum of 2 megawatt of plant can be connected with this single Smart Energy Manager. So the system diagram for this Smart Energy Manager, it has been shown here. For example, there are 10 number of inverters which are connected in parallel with the grid. So this particular Smart Energy Manager will be coming with CTs, or else you can procure the CTs on from your side, because the cable diameter or the busbar size may differ. So it all what do we recommend is that you go with the CT as per the requirement of the cable sizing or the busbar sizing. So this particular CT needs to be connected at the grid side before the load, and this particular connection is given to this particular Smart Energy Manager, and this Smart Energy Manager communicates with all the inverters through DAISY chain on RS-485. You can connect the LAN cable to the Smart Energy Manager, which in turn will be connected to our cloud, and all the data for the Smart Energy Manager can be viewed on our portal. So this is a small table for the selection of the Smart Energy Manager. So how you need to select this particular Smart Energy Manager, there are some points that we'll be discussing here. The first one is the size of the solar power plant. For example, if it is a single inverter or multiple inverter, if it is a 50 kilowatt inverter or 1 megawatt plant, that we need to first of all identify what is the size of the solar power plant and the overall consumption of the load. That is very important, because you can connect up to 1 megawatt of your solar power plant, but at the same time, if the consumption or the power consumption at the load side is up to 3 to 4 megawatt, then accordingly you need to change the size of the city. So all these parameters we need to consider before selecting a proper city for the Smart Energy Manager. This is the second point which I was discussing, the maximum current through the main switch. That is the maximum load that is available at the site. That also needs to be considered, and depending on that, we need to find out the maximum current and then select a particular city that is applicable for this particular solution. And the last and the most important thing is that the inward diameter of the city needs to be considered, because if that city is not able to get connected in the provided bus bar or the cable, then it will be very difficult to go for the zero export functionality. Now, for example, if you are considering a 50 kilowatt single inverter plant, then for that particular scenario, we can go with a single meter, zero export or a three phase meter with city. And then as we will go on increasing the size of the plant, that is for 30 kilowatt, usually 600 ampere city we are providing with the Smart Energy Manager, up to 2 megawatt, that is a 4000 by 5 ampere city is provided complimentary along with the Smart Energy Manager. But at the same time, you need to consider this particular data, that is the diameter or the inland diameter of the city, if it is possible to place this city in that particular environment or not. And the second most important part is that all this data can be viewed on our monitoring portal. For example, what is the self consumption, how much power that has been that was being generated by solar is being utilized for the internal load, and how much of the power has been exported back to the grid. This data can be easily viewed on our online portal. Also, on the same way, how much power has been consumed by the load from the solar part, and how much of the power has been consumed by the load through grid. So all this particular data can be viewed on a single monitoring portal, so that it becomes very easy for you to analyze that how much of power is being utilized by the load by solar and how much is being utilized by the grid. So all that data can be easily viewed on your monitoring portal, and also it is possible to download this particular data. Now this was just an overview of how we have to do the how will be the overall system design for single phase, three phase, and when you are going with a multiple number of inverters. So in that particular case, now how we are going to do the system configuration and system connections, that we will be discussing in the coming slides. So now when we are talking about the single phase inverters, so for that we will require a single phase meter, And when we are talking about the egg series, that is in single phase, that is the MIC series from 1 kilowatt up to 3.3 kilowatt, and the MIN series from 4.2 kilowatt up to 5 kilowatt. So all these inverters comes with inbuilt RS-485 connection. So basically, when we are talking about the connection of this particular single phase meter, so you can see the grid side needs to be connected at this particular at the point number one, and the load side, that is going towards the load or the inverter, needs to be connected at the connection number two. At the same time, the neutral side needs to be of the neutral of the grid needs to be connected at the connection number three, and the neutral of the load needs to be connected at point number four. So this particular inverter will be connected between your grid side and the load side. Now talking about the RS-485 connection that we need to do. So for a single phase inverter, we are providing a 8-pin connector in which 7 number and 6 number are being used for the RS-485 connection. And pin number 5 and 6 on the meter needs to be connected to this particular RS-485 connection in the connector. You need to take care that the RS-485B is connected to the RS-485B of the inverter, and the RS-485A of the meter is connected to the RS-485A of the inverter. Otherwise, there will not be any communication between the meter and the inverter, and the zero export functionality will not work properly. So this care needs to be taken. Now when we are talking about the three phase, so for the three phase also, it is if you are using a direct meter without the CTs, the connections will be same. But in case if you are going for a CT based meter, then in that particular scenario, the CTs need to be connected between your load and the grid side, and you need to take care that the direction or the position of the CT is this one. The current the flow of current direction should be from grid towards your load. So P1 is to P2. So there is a marking given on the CT, P1, P2. So the P1 of the CT should always be facing towards your grid, and the P2 should be facing towards your load or the inverter. So you can see here, these are some of the connections that we have on the inverter. So basically C1, C2 for each CT needs to be connected at the current input of this particular meter. Also, it will be having one more connection for voltage. So L1, L2, L3 needs to be connected to this smart meter along with the CT connection. And for RS-485, there are two different ports. So that needs to be connected to 7 number pin and 8 number pin of the inverter's RS-485 connection. So this needs to be taken care only for our MID 17 to 25 kilowatt. Instead of 7 and 8, it will be 5 and 6. So this particular RS-485 connection diagram or this connector diagram is given in the manual. So you can refer the manual, or you can get in touch with our service team if you are facing any sort of issues for the connection of this particular RS-485 connection. So again, the direction of the CT plays a very important role for efficient working of the zero export functionality. So the direction of the CT should always be considered properly. For the Max series, again, it is the same. But for the Max series, we are having a different set of RS-485 connector. And for all other series, we will be providing this particular RS-485 connection. So if you are going with the max series from 50 to 80 kilowatt, then the only change will be the RS-485 connection. It is having a separate RS-485 pin connector at the termination points. So you just need to connect point A to A of meter and point B to point B of meter. That's it. All other connections will be same. So if you want to activate the configuration of zero export functionality, so all the X series of inverters which are coming with OLED display, this particular functionality can be activated from the display itself. So you just need to go in the advanced menu of the inverter, then it will prompt for a password. The password is 123 for single phase inverters, and if you are going for three phase inverters, it will be 111. So after entering the password, it will ask for zero export limit function. If you want to turn it on, just select the on and press the enter button. Then it will ask for a meter, so select the meter, and then comes the export limit rate. Now basically the export limit rate means that whatever the percentage you are setting over here, for example 70%, so the 70% of the nominal power of the inverter will be supplied as a will be exported back to the grid. For example, if it is a 50 kilowatt inverter and you have set the export limit rate to 70%, then maximum of 35 kilowatt of power it will be supplying back to the grid. Now if this particular rate, if you are setting it to zero, then it will not provide any power back to the grid. And after that, for zero export, basically this needs to be kept at 0% only. This you need to note it down, and after that then just set OK and your zero export functionality will be on. So this is the first step how we are configuring the zero export functionality to our LED display. The second option is that you can do the same configuration through your online account or through local commissioning page. So for local commissioning page, I will not discuss it right now, but because for that you require a separate set of USB debugging stick. So when you are just connecting that particular stick to your USB port of the inverter and through your ShinePhone application, you can just connect your inverter with your mobile, and you need to go in the quick setting options. When you are going in the quick setting options, it will ask for a zero export limit. You need to tick this particular option, and then you need to select the option on with meter. The second option is, again, you need to set the zero export limit power at 0% for zero export functionality. And the third and the most important thing is that default power percentage after failsafe. That is, in any case, if your RS-485 communication breaks or your meter becomes faulty, then in that case, what is the power that inverter should feed back to the grid? That particular percentage you can set it over here. So if you are setting it to zero, and if the load is full and the inverter is generating at the full power, but in case the communication breaks or the meter gets faulty, then automatically this particular failsafe function will get activated, and it will set the output power of inverter to 0%, and it will not, until the communication is not established again or the meter is not exchanged or replaced, till that particular time the inverter will not be exporting any power back to the grid. And yes, if you are going through your online portal, then this particular functionality can be turned on by our service engineer, because it requires a password. And when you are going into the inverter settings, so just go into the device list and click on the setting button, and then this set of parameters will be available. But to change these particular parameters, we require a special kind of password, which is available only with our service team. So if your plant is online and you need to turn on the export limit functionality, then you just set this particular parameter to enable the meter, set the percentage of the export power, default power after export limit failure, and then just save the parameters, and your export functionality will be on through your online portal also. So this particular functionality can be turned on through OSS or our online portal also. But for that particular case, your inverter should be online through GPRS or RS-485 or Wi-Fi on our portal. Then only it is possible to do the configuration through our portal. Otherwise, you can go with display or with the help of our engineers. Now, yes, how we have to do the cable connections for Smart Energy Manager when we are going for multiple number of inverters. For example, we are using here 10 number of grow watt inverters and a single Smart Energy Manager. So from the Smart Energy Manager, the cities needs to be connected between again your load and the grid, and this city connection goes to your Smart Energy Manager, and through RS-485 it will be communicating through to all your inverters. So this is a daisy chain configuration that we need to follow. So your Smart Energy Manager will be your master, and your first inverter will be followed after your Smart Energy Manager. So you just need to connect A to A and B to B, and we recommend to use a grounding cable also, so that there is no external interference in the communication. And up to 500 meters you can go with the Smart Energy Manager from your first that is from your master till your last inverter. Maximum distance that you can go is up to 500 meters, and in this way daisy chain you need to go to configurations from Smart Energy Manager to your first inverter, and from first inverter to your second inverter till your last inverter, you need to carry out in the same configuration, that is the daisy chain configuration. So how we need to do the connections? So basically these are the connections. If you see, these are the connection diagrams or the connection details for our Smart Energy Manager. It is very important to provide a earthing separately to this particular Smart Energy Manager, so that there is no interference. I'm again repeating, because this is very important, because due to any interference, the communication can break and the power can be exported back to the grid. So for that particular reason, you need to take care that grounding has been done to the Smart Energy Manager. Again, for reference, we need to provide L1, L2, L3. And for the city connection, for the three phases, again, we need to follow the same as we have discussed earlier. The only thing you need to understand is that for L3, IC1 and IC2, that is, this combination needs to be followed properly. It's not like that if it is L3 and this particular CT is being placed in L1 and given connection to IC. It's L3 will be corresponding to IC, L2 will be corresponding to IB, and L1 corresponds to IA. So the phase which you are connecting to the inverter and to the meter, the city needs to be connected in the same phase, and the connection needs to be given to the same connection point in the Smart Energy Manager. So this particular connection diagram needs to be followed rigorously. There should not be any mistake, done in this particular connection diagram. And after that, the RS-485 connection is there, and grounding cable or the grounding connection needs to be done. So if you are going with Cat5 or Cat6 cable, then one connection needs to be given to the grounding point, and then you'll need to lay the cable in the daisy chain in this way to the remaining inverters one by one. So this needs to be taken care properly. And again, the direction of the CT plays a very important role. The P1 will be facing towards your grid side, and the P2 will be facing your load side. So this also needs to be taken care of. And this RJ45 connector is for the connection of internet through Ethernet cable. Once all the connections are done, we need to do the configuration of the smart energy manager. So this particular Shine smart energy manager has a internal Shine master. So we need to connect our laptop through RJ45 connector with the Shine master and open the configuration page. For this particular configuration, our service engineers will help you out for doing the configuration. By default, the meter channel will be RS-485-2, and when you are going for any inverter connection, you have to go for RS-485 channel 1. So these are the by default, the address will be 1, and you don't need to change this particular address. By default, the export limit function will be off, and you need to click the on button to turn on the zero export functionality. And here you can select how much of power you need to export back to the grid, and it will be in kilowatt. For example, if you are keeping this at 100 kilowatt, so maximum 100 kilowatt of power will be exported back to the grid. If you are setting this export limit power to zero, then no power will be exported back to the grid, and all the power will be utilized only for the internal consumption. Then we need to activate this fallback, because this is very important. Once you have activated this fallback function, you need to specify the active power during the fallback is activated. That is, whenever your smart energy manager will not communicate with your inverters, or if it fails down, then what is the maximum power it should feedback to the grid, that you need to specify over here. And after that, after how many seconds this fallback function should get activated about, when your communication fails or smart energy manager fails, that we need to specify over here. For example, 120 seconds, that is 2 minutes after the failure of your smart energy manager or your communication, this fallback function will get activated. The reactive power regulation needs to be kept off, and then just save this particular page and all the settings that we have done in the smart energy manager. So this is the particular section where how we are doing particular configuration for single phase, three phase, and if you are having multiple number of inverters, how we are doing the configuration and the connection was being explained over here. So if you are having any questions regarding this, you please write down your questions, and towards the end of this particular webinar, I will try to clarify all your doubts, or else we are also getting the questionnaires on our mail ID. So I will revert back to you through our through the mails also if you are having any questions on that. And the last section of this particular webinar is basically on the frequently asked questions, that the possible questions that may arise during the commissioning of the zero export functionality, or how is it. So the first frequently asked question is, the export limit function is not working. That is, you have done all the connections, you have turned on the zero export functionality, but still the inverter is not able to control the power as per the load demand. So in that particular case, we again need to check that the zero export functionality is turned on or not, and what is the limit power rate. For example, if you are setting it at 100%, then there will be no zero export functionality. So the limit power rate also needs to be specified at the time of configuration. And still, if it is correct, then you need to check for the RS-485 cable connection, or if it is a city-based meter, then you need to check the direction of the city if it is properly connected, as we have stated in the earlier slides, or not. And still, if you are not getting the zero export functionality, then I would like to suggest you to get in contact with our service engineer, and he will help you out for the proper solution. The second thing is that the self-consumption data is not getting updated on our server or on the Shine phone. So in this particular case, the meter needs to be on and connected with our inverter properly. If it is not connected with the inverter through RS-485 properly, then the data of the meter will not be available on our server. The second thing is that you need to check that the zero export functionality has been turned on properly. If still after doing all these things still you are facing the same problem, then it is recommended to set the register 55321. Now this particular register setting will be done by our engineer. And after doing that also, if there is some issue, then definitely our service engineer will help you out for a proper solution. The third probable question is that you can't see the 24-hour self-consumption on the monitoring portal. Now, we need to take care that all our X series of inverters are with the version of AC power supply. Basically, what happens during the night time when the inverters shut down, the inverter is trying to take all the power from your DC side, and it consumes no power during the night from your AC side. But we need to turn on that particular functionality that the inverter should run on the AC power. But the only disadvantage of this thing is that it will consume some power from your grid during the night time, which we do not recommend. Again, it depends on the end customer. If he requires to have a 24-hour self-consumption monitoring, then in that particular case, we need to check that the inverters supplied are with the AC power supply version or not. If it is not with that version, then it is not possible to have 24-hour self-consumption monitoring. Yes, the export limit, the very frequent and question is that the export limitation function is not working. So again, as we have discussed, maybe there will be some communication issue between the meter and the inverter, or you have not connected the cities properly, or the export limitation function is not turned on, or the export limit rate is not set accurately. So you, first of all, you need to check all these particular functions that we have discussed in the earlier side. And still, if you are facing the issue, then the last option is to get in contact with our service engineer, and then he will help out to do the proper configuration again. And if you are talking about a smart energy manager, that is for the multiple inverters, if still for that also the self-consumption data is not getting updated, then first of all you need to check that the meter connection is correct. And as we are using here Ethernet connection, we need to check that there is no protection or firewall available on that particular LAN connection. Because if there is any sort of protection on the LAN connection, then their server will not allow to push the data to Grovot server. So in that particular case, we need to take care that the port 5027 needs to be unblocked in the server of the customer. That we need to take care, because the smart energy manager will be basically or majorly used for the industrial applications, and most of the industries doesn't allow the data to go out of their server. So that, because of that, it would not be possible to get the data on our portal. So you need to take care that the firewall is deactivated for a particular IP address, and the block and the port number 5027 is not blocked. That these two things you need to take care. So thank you once again for all of you for attending this particular webinar on Zero Export functionality. We still are having some time, so I will try to take some of the questions from your side and try to clarify your doubts. So I'm just opening the question point. Yeah, can we connect? I think this question is from just a minute. There is please once again explain metering solution. I will Mr. Abhijit, I will get in contact with you for the same, and we can discuss this, because it will again take more time. So I will get back to you on that definitely. Yeah, Mr. Deepak has asked that is there a central inverter available or not? No, sir. Grovot is only manufacturing string inverters, so we do not have any central inverters available with us. Yes, this particular this is from Mr. Manish. Yes, sir. This particular PPT we will be sharing with all of you on the mail IDs that you have given for the registration. So after this webinar is over, we will share all the this particular PPT with all of you. So I think if you are having any sort of questions or any there is one more question. If you have a 450 kilowatt project and we have the maximum higher capacity for Grovot is only, so we have to connect it through a busbar system, or how it will be? Yes, for a 450 kilowatt project, this is from Mr. Bonnie Anthony. So if you are having a 450 kilowatt project, then definitely all the output of the inverter will be combined together to a single bus bar. But if you are going for zero export functionality, we don't need to take the feedback from the output of the inverter. But as I have stated earlier, it needs to be connected at the grid side, that is the main input and between the load. Then only it is possible for us to properly work the zero export functionality. So again, we need to take care that it is not connected at the output or the combined output of the inverters, but at the grid side. The zero export meter needs to be connected at the grid side. This you need to take care before installing. Can you share your contact number? Yes, I'm just sharing my mobile number with all of you. For any particular query, you can get back to me. So I think these are the questions that we are having right now. So this PPT will be shared with you all. So there is one more. Yeah, Nihit Kumar, his sir is asking that zero export functionality may be synchronized with load fluctuation. I'm not exactly getting the question. What do you mean by load fluctuation? But yes, basically zero export functionality works as per the load demand. So for example, just a small example, I am giving of 10 kilowatt and the load demand is of maybe you say 20 kilowatt at that particular time. So the 10 kilowatt will be supplied by inverter and the remaining 10 kilowatt will be taken by the grid. But in the case when the load demand falls to 5 kilowatt, so in that particular case, the zero export meter will give the command back to the inverter to ramp down the output power to 5 kilowatt. So this 10 kilowatt inverter will be giving output of only 5 kilowatt as this is the demand of the load. If the demand increases to 7 kilowatt, then again the meter detects that the load demand has increased and again it will give the feedback to the inverter to ramp up its power. So this is a very dynamic process depending on the load conditions. One more. Does zero export solar system needs inspector approval? No. Basically, zero export functionality is majorly used because as you all know that the net metering is getting delayed by about 2 to 3 months or maybe more than that. And in some of the states, the net metering is not available at all. So what you can do once you're plant or a solar power plant is commissioned and net metering is still not done, in that particular case you can go for zero export functionality. And till the inspector doesn't visit your site and use the approval for net metering, you can utilize the solar power for internal consumption. So that is the main reason that most of the people are going for zero export functionality. Using in fringe areas with poor network connectivity, will the SMA function independently irrespective of internet will work irrespective of internet connection? This question is asked by Mr. Sahil. Yes, sir. The internet is only required for monitoring the inverter and the load consumption online. If internet is not available, still your zero export functionality will work. Only you need to activate the zero export functionality in the inverter, and once it is activated, it will start working even though internet connection is not there. So internet connection is not compulsory for the working of zero export limitation. There is one more question. In case of multiple inverters, the SEM will ramp down all individual inverters together or one by one depending on the excess energy trending to flow to the grid? Yeah, this is a good question. When you are using a smart energy manager, for now I will be also explaining this with an example. If there are 10 inverters of 50 kilowatt, that is 500 kilowatt is being connected with smart energy manager. So in case the power drops down to or the load demand is only 250 kilowatt, So in this particular case, the smart energy manager will give command to all the 10 inverters to reduce down the power to 50%. That is, each inverter will be giving an output of only 25 kilowatt. So when you are using a smart energy manager, the command goes to all the inverters simultaneously. Yes, as it is a RS-485 communication, so the response time for the first inverter and the last inverter will be different, but this particular response time is within milliseconds, so it will not affect the overall functionality. That's why you need to take care that the distance between your smart energy manager and the last inverter should not be more than 500 meters, so that the zero export functionality works good when you are using a smart energy manager. So I think these are the questions that we have got from your side. And once again, if some of the questions, if I have missed out, definitely I will get back to all your questions through mail. And I have shared my mobile number to all of you. So if you are having any doubts, definitely you can get back to me on that. So thank you once again for attending this particular webinar. And I was not able to turn on my video because I was facing some internet issues. But again, thank you once again for attending this particular webinar and making it a good success. And if you are having any queries regarding this particular export limitation solutions provided by GrowWatt, you can directly get in contact with me. And thank you once again. Be safe, stay at home, take care. And still the situation is not good, so try to remain home in order to prevent yourself from this COVID pandemic. So thank you once again, and signing off from myself. Thank you. Thank you for this particular, for your presence for this particular webinar. Thank you. Thanks a lot.